Sometimes I feel like throw my hands up in the air. I know I can count on you. Sometimes I feel like saying, Lord, I just don't care. But you got the love I need to see me through. Sometimes it seems the going is just too rough.
I'm here outside Dunfermline Abbey, where I'll be interviewing the Associate Minister, Reverend Ian Payton. Firstly, thanks for being here. What would you say Jesus' attitude towards the poor was?
Well, I think we'd say, first of all, that Jesus sympathised with the poor. I think you get that sort of coming through in the Gospels, that Jesus was sympathetic to the poor. But it depends how you define poor. There's money, but there's other things as well. For instance, in the Beatitudes, Jesus is saying, blessed are the poor in spirit.
Yes.
So it's not just money. And then you find that there's a lot of healing miracles. So Jesus is healing those who are poor in health,
yes,
you could say, as well. And when you talk about the poor, you've also got to say, well, what's Jesus' attitude to the rich?
Yes.
Because that is also the case. There's the case in the Bible of the rich young ruler who came to Jesus and said, what will I do to inherit eternal life? And he said, go and give what you've got to the poor. And said, now that's fine, I can sit back and enjoy life. And Jesus says, you fool, this night your life will be required of you.
Yes.
In other words, you've done all of this, but you've only done it to satisfy yourself. Mm-hmm. And what good is that? You can't sort of take it with you. So I think he never condemns wealth itself. It's a question of what you do with it. And what you do with it is to help the poor.
Mm-hmm.
So that we're aiming towards equality,
yeah,
which is somewhere we'll never get to, but mm-hmm, that's where we're going.
All right, thanks.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. What would you say Christians do to help the poor?
To help the poor. Well, as far as what Christians do, I suppose what we should always say is, well, what would Jesus do?
Mm-hmm.
What would Jesus' response be in a certain situation? And with the poor, well, what do you do? You help. We that the rich should help the poor. And that again comes down to an equality, which is what I was saying a moment ago. Now, how do Christians do that?
Equality within the world. So how then should we treat the poor?
Okay, well, love your neighbour. And who's your neighbour? Well, there's a parable about that. It's not just your next door neighbour, but in any case, it's always difficult to say, well, in what way is your neighbour poor?
Mm-hmm.
As I said at the beginning, it can be poor in spirit, it can be poor in outlook, it can be poor in many things, poor in health. Help your neighbour and love your neighbour as you love yourself. Okay. Who says that God is on the side of the poor? That's sometimes been asked. People say, God loves the poor, God's on the side of the poor. But I've also heard people say, well, yes, well, but where does it say that in the Bible? It doesn't actually say that. We know that Jesus helped the poor, but I think he also helped the rich so that they would help the poor.
Yeah, in the Bible I've read that he writes things to advise the rich on how to treat the poor.
That's right.
He says not to approach him tight-fisted and to welcome them,
mm-hmm,
as you would someone mm-hmm, in your family. So with that in mind, if we were to come across somebody who was poor in wealth and who didn't have what we had, how would we then treat that person?
Okay, well, yes, you would do what you can to help that person. You've got to be very careful sometimes how you help person, because charitable giving is quite hard, that you don't offend people
mm-hmm,
when you're doing it. You do with it, and what you do with it is to is to help the poor, so that we're aiming towards equality, which is somewhere we'll never get to, but that's where we're going.
All right, thanks.
Okay.
So on to the final question. From reading the Bible, it tells us that Jesus obviously died for our sins, and he for the Christians has played a big part in their lives. So why then is there suffering in the world with these people who are poor in wealth and poor in health? Why are they suffering if Jesus is so apparent in their life?
Right, okay. I think that the whole business of sin is a terribly difficult one for all of us to understand. We're told that, go back to Adam and Eve, and sin came right at the beginning, and there's a very clever story in the book of Genesis that sin came in the form of a serpent. And that sin has been with humankind ever since. Jesus came, it says, to take away the sins of the world onto ourselves. I think he still does that spiritually, in that in church services here, most Sundays, in our prayers of confession, where the congregation is encouraged to confess their sins inwardly to Jesus, and that if we seriously ask for our sins to be forgiven, that they will be. Jesus, in a spiritual sense, will take our sins. Now that's fine, that's for the
it isn't over. Never.